Hi people, today's video is all about diabetes. So in this video we are going to show you the top 5 asanas which can easily be practiced at home by you. So you don't have to have a very advanced level of yoga practice to practice this. Even if you are a housewife or a person who cannot do a lot of advanced practice or very new to yoga, even though you can practice this. So today for this asana practice we are using a yoga belt. So if you don't have yoga belt at home, you can also use a dupatta or anything which in this length to make your practice easy and you don't feel like you're doing a lot. Second thing, for one of the practice we'll be using a prop of chair. So you can use any chair at home which is available easily. Make sure you don't have a lot of a length problem with the chair. It should be like very normal, so you don't have a lot of difficulty while practicing. So let's start the first practice. As you guys know that in diabetes, you need to focus a lot on the pancreas, which stimulates the insulin. So the first practice is all about pancreas. So in this practice, you keep your both the legs straight and bend your right knee. Keep your right heel closer to the knee. So that is a proper balance. And keep your back straight. And then lift your left hand up straight with the inhalation. Exhale, turn towards the outside. From the elbow, try to push your knee inside. And opposite hand will be behind the spine. Look outside. Your posture will look something like this. And your toes will be very much active. And stay here for few breaths. And once you are comfortable, and once you are there for few breaths, slowly come out of the asana. And practice the same thing opposite side. Bend your left knee, keep your heel next to the knee. Take your right hand up straight with the inhalation. While exhaling, twist yourself completely out and look outside. Keep your toes active. Do abdomen breathing, that means inhale, exhale through the stomach. And once you feel like you're there for some time, slowly come out of the asana. And relax for at least 30 seconds. Next one is Paschimottanasana. For this, sit down on your hips, keep your both the legs straight, toes active, and then take your both the hands up straight with the inhalation. While exhaling, from the hip, exhale, bend forward. Try to hold your toes or the heel however possible. If you can hold your toes very easily, you can keep your elbows bent and slowly go down how much ever you can depending on your capacity. If you can go down completely, that's okay, but then don't try to round your shoulder. Try to keep your back flat. You can see the back is completely flat. And then slowly come up. With inhalation, lift your both the hands up and drop it down. Now the variation, if you cannot do such a nice forward bending, say you are very new to the practice, if you cannot do it, keep your both the knee bent but toes active, hold your big toe from first three fingers, and then while exhaling slowly start moving your heels away from each other, but then keep your back straight. If you think your capacity is only so much for now, you cannot move forward, absolutely fine, just stay there. But then if you are feeling comfortable, slowly move one step ahead. Try to keep your calf muscles completely on the floor and then maintain this posture where your back is flat. We can stay here and then after few breaths, of course, lift your both the hands up again with the inhalation and then exhale, you can relax. The third one would be cobra posture. It's again very simple, for which lie down on the floor on your stomach. Keep your toes outside, heels together and palm next to the chest, fingers open. Drop your chin down. With the inhalation, slowly try to raise your chest up towards the sky, pushing the floor away from the chest. Keep your elbows straight, feel the stretch in your back and keep your chin in the front. Chest open. Lot of time what happens, you tend to squeeze your neck, but try to keep it open how much ever possible. After few breaths, slowly come down with the help of elbow. Try to bend the elbow and drop your chin down and the chest down. Say like if you have any sort of a back problem, you cannot stay there in a complete stretch posture. You have a variation in which again you will bend your chest slightly up, but then you don't keep your elbows straight. You can keep your elbows bent. This is also very effective. So just stay here, stomach slightly engaged and the hip engaged. Inhale, exhale for few breaths and then slowly come out of the posture. And you can relax in any of the posture. If you feel like you need a break, you can relax in child posture or Makarasana. Just cross your both the hands, drop your head down and relax for few breaths, and you can continue the practice. Moving forward, the fourth best asana for diabetes. In here, you can continue from the Bhujangasana itself. So as you see, you're lying down on the floor, your entire stomach as well as entire body is on the floor. Bend your knee slowly. Try to hold your ankle from the wrist, toes facing you, and then slowly raise your chest up as well as thighs up. Here you can go up how much ever you can. Make sure you keep your knees together. Sometimes what happens, knees goes apart from each other. Try to control over that and be here, chest open, stay there for few breaths, focus on the stomach, and then slowly come out of the posture and make sure that you relax after each posture, and preferably relax in a child posture. Stay there calm, make sure your hip goes down completely and stay for a while. If at all you find it difficult that your hand doesn't reach your legs, or if you find it difficult, we have a variation in which again you'll be lying down on the floor, bend your both the knee, take a help of a strap. So now we are going to use the strap here. So hold the strap from your both the hands and try to hold a middle of the strap to the ankle, something like this, which you can see in the video. And slowly here, try to lift your chest up, do not bend your elbows, and just focus on the chest to come up. Thighs only if you can, otherwise how much ever you can. When you practice, automatically you can see the flexibility is increasing and you can come to a complete Dhanurasana posture. Keep your both the ankles together, hips slightly engaged. Importantly, elbows straight. You tend to bend your elbows if you do not have a proper idea about the posture, but then keep it straight. Hold here for a couple of breaths and then slowly come down. Remove the strap, keep it aside and relax. Preferably child posture, just to give the opposite stretch to the back. Stay there for a few breaths. Moving on, the last top fifth asana, which is very effective for diabetes. So for this asana, we'll be using the chair. So you can have any chair at home, generally easily available. To practice this asana, it's very easy. So you know the chair is here already next to the head. So now slowly lift your both the legs up with inhalation and try to drop your toes to the table. Here, try to raise your hip how much ever possible, depending on your capacity. You don't have to force yourself, but see how comfortable you are doing this. And if you are comfortable, you can also hold your upper back to give a support so that you know you are stable here. And once you get a better balance through the hands, then you can drop your hands down. Otherwise, make it very simple. As you see, both the toes are here. Just hold here for a few breaths. And then if you think you are advanced practitioner, you can do it without the chair also. You can slowly, I'll remove the chair. Without the chair, slowly drop your both the toes to the floor, in which you can see the back is completely straight. Your hands are on the floor and your toes are straight in the floor again. Stay there for a few breaths and then with the inhalation slowly get your hip down to the floor and relax. While practicing this, if at all you feel that you're losing balance at any point, the best thing what you can do is you can bend your knee. By practicing which, you won't fall down on the floor. So bend your knee, you will land on the floor very safely. So you have seen the top 5 best asanas for diabetes. You can practice early in the morning, but you need to do something else also to get it better. So pranayama. So what are the pranayamas which are very effective for diabetes? So there are 3 things which you can do every day. So first one is abdomen breathing. When you do abdomen breathing, you should feel it. So what happens, generally when we breathe, we don't even give any attention. So we don't know what is going on. So that's the reason we'll keep one hand on the chest and one hand on the stomach and keep your eyes closed and inhale completely inside the stomach and exhale out. So basically what are you doing here is you are taking inside the air and filling your stomach and expanding it out. And when you are exhaling, you are taking the stomach completely inside. That means you are emptying the air inside the stomach and exhaling out totally. So do it with a lot of relaxed movements. Take it long as possible. Keep a long inhale and long exhalation. Do it for at least 10 to 15 counts. And then once you feel like you have done enough, then you can slowly stop the practice. You can remove the hands and keep it on the thighs. Second one is Nadi Shuddhi. So we have around 72,000 nadis in our body, and if you don't have any balance over it, then you'll find a lot of problems. So practicing this will get a lot of balance in these 72,000 nadis, and also very effectively works on the diabetes as well. So to practice this, keep your left hand in chin mudra, as you can see here, touching your two fingers together, and right hand, keep your thumb on the nostril. So you can change your nostril when you practice. So keep your left right nostril closed, inhale from the left and close the left nostril, exhale from the right. Again, inhale from the right, close your right nostril, exhale from the left. Close it again, exhale from the right. So you have to do this repeatedly. So what you're doing is a simple U-turn. Inhale from one side, exhale from other. Again, inhaling from other side, exhaling from this. So continuous practice of this will create a proper balance in the nadis as well as works on the diabetes. So third one is Kapalbhati. So to practice Kapalbhati, keep your both the hands in chin mudra, as you can see here right now. Keep your back flat, close your eyes, inhale completely inside, exhale forcefully from the nose. As you can see here, your shoulders are not moving, your stomach is not moving, only your breathing pattern is having an effect. Keep exhaling forcefully from the nose. Inhale should be seamless. You don't have to drag your breath. You can practice this on the counts, maybe 50 counts, 100 counts. You can start from even 20 counts, and you can practice how much ever possible from your end. And once you stop the breath after a few counts, keep your eyes closed and observe what works. How do you feel in your breath? It should be very much relaxed. And advisably, if you have BP, then probably you can ignore this one pranayama, because this is not very good for BP, for high blood pressure. Then if you have only diabetes, then definitely you can practice. So we have seen these three pranayamas, which you can practice along with the diabetes, other asanas, and preferably try it in the early morning in an empty stomach. So keep practicing and stay healthy.